whatever Bosch's pictures may be about, they depict the life of his contemporaries as one of imminent calamity and misery. Medieval European man was solemn, and smiles weren't exchanged naturally when people greeted one another. Smiling overmuch was sinful, and tears were frequent in church during the telling of tales in ordinary conversation. And to weep was no shame for even the bravest of men. Contrasts were marked. The poor begged in the streets, showed dreadfully maimed limbs, and starved in public. The great lived in ostentatious splendor. People spoke loudly and did everything noisily, indoors and out. But by night, all was silent. The streets deserted except for the homeless and the evil. Houses darkened and still. Calamity was bewailed aloud. A cry in the night was murder. A light in the night was arrest. Voices in the night were marauders and evildoers. The unknown and the different was devilry and to be put down. The age was sad, pessimist, expecting evil as man's ineluctable destiny, and snatching at joys because they were inescapably short-lived. Hell beckoned, and the detailed inventory of its tortures was known, studied, embellished, and brandished before children and adults. Heroic virtue and the intercession of saints might save some, but the most by far, were dead. furnaces burning through the night. The revolutionary new iron smelting technique near the city of Liège would have been the talk of any town.